Hello, Miss Mary.
Hi.
I'm going to tell you a little bit about what we're doing here today, and then we're going to get into our questions. Is that all right with you?
That sounds great.
Okay. The SAG-AFTRA Foundation is announcing a new initiative called Home Stage, which I hope many of our fellow SAG-AFTRA artists will participate in. Home Stage is an online archive that documents the various ways in which you have or are using your home to get through our shared COVID-19 crisis. To offer some inspiration, I am speaking with SAG-AFTRA artist Mary Neely, who many of you know from her absolutely awesome homemade videos she's been sharing with the world during this pandemic. Mary recreated musicals such as Phantom of the Opera, Les Mis, and Disney's Beauty and the Beast, and more on her social media. They're all very funny, very creative. And I'm delighted to speak with her about some of the ideas that inspired her videos and share some of her tips about her creative process. Hello, Mary. Yes, twice I've asked, said hello to you. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, wonderful. I'm excited. I'm very excited. So my first question is that very thing. What is it that inspired you to make such wonderful videos? Was it being holed up and during the pandemic? Was it being bored? Was it your love of musicals? Was it all of the above? What was it?
All of the above, for sure. I found myself wanting to have things to do and be inspired. And, you know, editing is an amazing way to pass the time. And I've been a commercial actor for 7 years, but during that time, I started writing and directing my own projects and teaching myself how to edit just as I went along, and YouTube is very helpful for that. So I wanted to be able to have like a full service production, and luckily I'm obsessed with Halloween and themed parties, so I have many wigs and many pieces of clothing that are very outlandish, and in the past I judged myself for owning, but now I'm very happy that I own all of it.
We were wondering in our household, now where did she get all that stuff from?
I know.
So you have it all in your house.
I do. Yeah, the first thread that I did, I didn't buy anything. So those were all just things that I own. And I wanted it to be that way because I wanted to challenge myself, because I think that creative constraints can actually bring out things in a project that you never knew were there before. I really just wanted to bring back my love of musicals that I had when I was a kid. I used to listen to original cast recordings like every day after school, and they helped me a lot listening to musicals. It was very much like an escapist kind of coping mechanism that I created for myself. And I think right now everybody could use a little bit of an escape. And so I wanted to bring that kind of element of my life from the past and combine it with filmmaking that I've learned as an adult, and also just kind of going off the joke that I'm single and I live by myself and I want to feel like I'm in love. So I play the guy and the girl.
I think you got the girl this time and the guy. Yeah. So I was curious about some of the things you learned from going from one video to the next, as you did quite a few. What are some of the strategies and lessons you picked up through trial and error and experimentation?
Yeah, I learned a lot technically, because at the beginning, I made the videos very simple. I didn't really have a lot of coverage, so it usually was just like one shot each for each character, and I would do one character all the way through and kind of figure out the choreography, and then I would flip around and do the other character. But as I went along, I started becoming, because I was just holding my cell phone, but I had to learn where to hold the camera without like looking into the lens. And so I started becoming better at like where the camera was and camera movement, and just like teaching myself as I went, kind of like how I've done like editing.
Were you always holding the camera? Did you always continue to hold the camera? Did you place it on a stand? Did you get really sophisticated with that? What did you do?
Yeah, like it varied mostly. I was always holding it just with my and trying to emulate some kind of like jib or like kind of like you know, more expensive piece of filming equipment. There were some moments where I did put the phone like on a banister, or like I made a makeshift tripod out of just books and like a chair. So it really depended on like what the shot called for. But I did a second thread, which was kind of like my encore, which was The Sound of Music. I did every song from The Sound of Music. Partner with Broadway Cares and did a fundraiser, but I wanted to go harder on that one and kind of expand it and like raise the bar of the production value. So I did get a tripod. I even borrowed a friend's drone. So I really, really upped the ante for the second round.
we're gonna you're gonna need to keep it up because we want some more.
Oh,
so
wow.
keep that that drone.
I already gave it back. But I
yes. You had to give it back. Well, we want you to get it back from that person because you're going to need it. We're going to want to see more. Now, I know you've been to our foundation before, and I'm wondering what were some of your highlights in terms of your experiences or programs that you took part in, especially, and did they come into play, your visit and the things you saw, did they come into play as you went into this phase of your life with these videos?
Oh, I mean, I think a lot of things that I learned from going to SAG Foundation screenings and Q&As have just like informed me as an actor and a filmmaker. I went to a lot of like film screenings with the Q&A after, either with the filmmakers or usually with the actors or whatever. I went to so many of those, like when I was first starting to do commercials 7 years ago, and I still go. Like I just went to one a few months ago. I went to the Just Mercy screening. Daniel Cretton film that with Jamie Foxx was there, and so was like a bunch of the other members of the cast. And I always find something that is helpful or useful. Like I love Q&As. I love listening to podcasts of like filmmakers or actors who I really admire, but there's something so special about going to the screening and seeing it in person and being part of that. And you guys always choose really amazing moderators. Like I've seen Janelle Riley, who, you know, writes for Variety like many times, and she always has really incredible questions. And so I've really loved like everything that I've gone to at the SAG Foundation. And like some highlights, like I remember seeing Blue is the Warmest Color with Adele Markopoulos, who, you know, they won the Palme d'Or at Cannes, and like that was really incredible. And I saw Rachel Bloom like doing like a screening for Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, and I've seen a lot of them, but those were like some highlights that I still think about. Those Q&As, I still think about things that people said, and I it's always in the back of my mind, like it pops in there, you know.
It's a wealth of information. So it's good to for our members to hear that that's there for them to be able to take advantage of. To, you know, and you may not go to some things and you find out some things that you didn't know and that may inspire you. So, as you know, the foundation is announcing our home stage initiative today, asking that performers share the various ways they're dealing with these unusual times. Now these can be videos, photos, or writing. There's really no limit. My question is, as an artist, who really sees the moment to use your personal and professional toolbox, are there any tips or words of advice you may be able to offer to others?
Yeah, I think just going for it is the main thing. Like, I am a big fan of Mark Duplass, and Mark you know, he's big in the indie film scene, and he has said in speeches and things like, if you're a filmmaker, if you're any kind of content creator, you should just be making things on your cell phone. Like, you should just be making a film every weekend with your friends, because the technology is so readily accessible to everybody. But to be honest with you, in the past, I kind of didn't really want to do that, because I became a filmmaker because I wanted to showcase myself as an actor. And I got used to like a high quality kind of set. Like I work on commercials. It's always like, you know, really nice cameras and a whole crew and all these things. And so I always like wanted to have that level of production in anything that I did. But now that we're in this pandemic, like I think about Mark Duplass and I'm like, he was right, because these videos have brought me so much joy and have really opened my career in this way that I never expected. And it was just me using my cell phone and just the things I had in my house. So there's nothing really stopping anyone right now, and we're all in the same boat. Production is potentially getting back underway, but it's not going to be the same. A lot of people are out of work, and there's really no reason why not to just do it and just go for it.
Mm-hmm. Well, we so appreciate you and all of your artistry. Dude, I'm sure everyone is wondering, what's next, Mary? What do you have in your toolbox for the next initiative? Can you share? Or are you gonna keep it close to the chest about it?
Well, I can say a few things. Like I made a music video in quarantine that I think is really fun. It's gonna soon. I actually shot a short film last summer that I just finished music for. So that did have a crew of people, and it is kind of like what I was.
Oh, you brought some other people in there, huh? All right, Mary.
Yeah, before all, it was like thing of the past now, it seems, I guess. But I'm almost done with that. So I'm submitting it to festivals, and I have a few other just like fun projects on the way. I'm really into photography too, and I've actually been taking a lot of film photos just during this time to kind of have like this time capsule moment or whatever. So I'm gonna get some of that film developed. So
oh, beautiful. Well, we will be sure to follow your work, Mary, and there will be an address on the screen so that people can do that. I'm sure we'll be very excited to hear about all the incredible exciting things, more exciting things you'll be doing in the future. Thank you so much for your time today, and thank you for sharing with us.
Oh, thank you so much for having me.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for those who are tuning in. I hope you enjoyed our initial foray into our new initiative, Homestage. I look forward to speaking with some of you in the future in future interviews. Stay safe, stay connected, and stay home. Grace and peace.